This edition of Wolf Tracks, high school students today, but they're working hard to become the stars of tomorrow. We'll take you backstage with SK's Acting Ensemble.
The SK football program keeps churning out top athletes. Tonight, meet star quarterback and defensive back, Jimmy Newell.
And parents flood the halls of SK. Come along for a trip to the traditional open house festivities. All that and much more tonight on Wolf Tracks. Hi, I'm Bridget O'Neill.
And I'm Chad O'Connell. Welcome to this edition of Wolf Tracks.
We're here at South Kitsap High School's track.
Whoa, Bridget, speak no more. Look what I just found. Needle in a haystack, Jimmy Newell's letterman's jacket. Let me put it on. I feel like I'm Jimmy Newell. I'm number 3, star quarterback. I'm 1,000 plus. I'm going to UW,
Chad,
what's up?
Chad,
I'm Jimmy Newell.
Chad, what's up? Yeah? You're not really him. Let's watch the real story on Jimmy Newell.
September 24th. The SK Wolves against Gig Harbor. In a hard-fought battle, the Wolves are up by 6. Third quarter, Gig Harbor is driving, and then...
Lester, he drops back. He's got a man wide open down the middle of the field.
Jimmy Newell's
down the defense, and it looks as if it's intercepted.
Interception.
And it is. It's a touchback. Interception by Jimmy Newell. Great defensive play by Newell.
Most people think of Jimmy Newell as the SK quarterback, but he stops the drive with perhaps the play of the game while playing defense. His 3.7 GPA and his versatility are some of the reasons Newell is a prep player being hotly pursued by the University of Washington. Jimmy was given the honor of being named one of the co-captains of the team.
Well, you have to lead by example. You don't necessarily have to be, you know, the rah-rah guy who's always screaming, go team, go team. You know, you can be, and that's great to have leaders like that, but I think that the number one thing you have to do is lead by example and you know, always do things right.
Over the summer, Jimmy impressed the scouts of the University of Washington and was offered a full scholarship.
Well, it was kind of surprising, and you know, I was really happy because, you know, I've kind of always been a dream of mine.
But he's taking it one step at a time.
You know, I'm kind of just looking at that as, you know, a bridge I'm going to cross when I get there. I'm not really worried about that. I'm just kind of focusing on this season.
Head coach DJ Siegerton has coached Newell for the past 3 years and relies on his ability.
The reason that he is difficult to defend against on offense is because he plays quarterback, and you don't normally try to stop a high school quarterback defensively. Your plan is to stop the running game or to stop the passing game with the quarterback that throws the ball, but to have a guy that's so athletic playing quarterback, it gives you just another dimension as far as a guy that can run.
It's hard to organize his time with football being so demanding.
Well, it's definitely not easy because, you know, we spend so much time here during the week. So, you know, you'll just go home after practice, you'll do your homework, and then, you know, you'll just relax, watch some TV, and then go to bed.
For Jimmy, life basically revolves around football.
I'd say, you know, a lot of my life revolves around football, especially during the season, because not only, I mean, it takes up a big chunk of your time, but also when you're at home, you know, you want to take that time to yourself and just relax.
Who knows what his future may hold at the UW, but one thing is certain, South Kitsap fans will long remember this talented athlete.
Out to the right, he takes a three-step drop, passes the ball out to Newell, and he's got the ball, there goes Newell, he makes a cut inside, a nice play, 5, touchdown South Kitsap!
Okay, I guess I'm not Jimmy Newell.
Yeah? On September 23rd, South Kitsap High School held an open house.
It was a chance for our parents to get a better look inside the school we attend.
Here's the story.
On Thursday, September 23rd, school was a little unusual. Instead of South being packed full of students, parents invaded the halls for the traditional open house of the new school year. Students and parents filled the gym for a short assembly. Principal Colombini welcomed everyone to the big night. And then it was time for some entertainment, courtesy of band, cheer, and dance team. In typical fashion, SK Pride was rocking.
It was full of school spirit, and it was a lot of fun for the parents to participate in.
It's great to see the gym and all the kids. Did a great job.
Yeah.
The night was off to a great start, and parents were sent on their way to visit classrooms. They followed their students' schedule, 10 minutes in each class. Open house is a great way for parents to meet the teachers and also get an insight as to what each class is all about. While the parents and teachers talk, students dreadfully wait at home, hoping nothing is said bad about them.
I think the turnout was unbelievably great. A lot of parents in the stands there. It was fun to see them. This is the second year that I've been involved in open house as a principal, and I was very, very, very excited.
For the most part, the parents were cooperative. However, we did have quite a few parents tardy to class.
Well, it was kind of scary because I couldn't find the room, and I couldn't find my way around, and I didn't know where it was.
Overall, open house was a great turnout. And one night, parents got a tour of the school and see what SK is all about.
Because we do need to form a partnership. This is truly a community high school.
I was a tour guide at the open house. It was a very well put on event by both Mr. Albertson and Mr. DeZone.
Up next is girls soccer, but first, an important message on alcohol. Growing in popularity.
Hang on. Women in soccer? Last I checked, soccer involved kicking, and I don't really think girls can kick. Okay, watch this story on girls' soccer. Sorry.
The girls' soccer team is on track again, playing tough and fighting hard. Coach Gary Troutman has been responsible for the hard practice that lead to game-winning skills.
And I'd have to say this year, our team has really come together. I mean, there's a lot of really young players, but they seem to have a lot of camaraderie, sometimes too much. They have a little too much fun every once in a while, but we seem to really get along well, and it's just, you know, a happy family almost. Just kind of corny, but that's the way it is.
The most inspirational player to me is Patty Blankenship because she just, I don't know, I've played with her for a long time and I've seen her improve so much over the years. And just, she's always got a level head and she's always giving constructive criticism, which a lot of good players don't. And I think that's really admirable.
Patty Blankenship spends about an extra hour after practice putting forth extra effort to make her a better player.
I'd have to say the most inspirational player this year for me has been Karen Ball because she's gone through an ACL tear and she's going to have her surgery soon. But she's always happy and she's staying upbeat about it. And it just makes me believe that I can get through anything if she can get through that.
Karen Ball, a team leader, started out with a good season, but is now benched due to an injury and won't be back for the rest of the season. The seniors receive their roses for their soccer years in hopes of a playoff shot in this season.
Can I just hold mine?
The things I'll miss about this team is like all the girls and how well we all get along, and just like it's just like one big family, and I'm just gonna miss everybody.
Okay, I guess you're right. Girls are good athletes. Hey, Bridget, you really should slow down on that thing there.
Have you ever tried this coffee? It's SK Latte coffee. It's so good. On a scale of 1 to 10, it's probably a 12 because 12 is higher than 10, and that's good. That's how good it is. It's better than any coffee I've ever had.
Thanks to SK Latte. Kids like Bridget have enough energy to stay up late at night and get all their homework done.
Are you going
to
say watch the next story? Are you going to say watch it? Say watch the next story, Chad. He's going to say it. Watch. Say it. Say it, Chad.
Why don't we watch the story on it?
Have you ever come to school and have that I wish I was still in bed feeling? Well, now there's a whole new reason to get up. That's right, South Kitsap now has their very own coffee shop, known simply as SK Latte.
Are you like the driving force behind this coffee shop thing?
Not the driving force, but we all have our own part, and I make sure everyone's doing it right.
Oh yeah, I mean, it's good business for the school. It's teaching the kids something, and hey, we can get some kids to have a little fun here. Why not, you know?
I like it. Coffee's a great thing.
So is it an actual class here at South?
Yes, business simulation.
Okay, so they get class credit for it.
Oh yeah.
In this hands-on learning experience, students learn how to take orders from customers, how to handle money, and how to make drinks.
So here are the masters at work. So what kind of training do you get to work here?
We get to learn how to make coffee and Italian sodas.
Coffee shop 101.
Definitely.
Yeah. Now, I don't know that you don't take any money for working here, so what does the money go for?
It goes to the class, to the funds, and to BPA, the Business Professionals of America Club.
So do you make money at this?
No, they won't even let us have a tip jar.
Oh, come on, seriously, how much do you make?
No, I'm no joke.
I won't tell
no
anyone.
Joke. No
I
joke.
Promise.
I can't let in on the secrets. Sorry.
Okay.
Okay, that's all fine and dandy, but how do they compare to other coffee shops?
Are you a Java junkie?
Yeah.
You are? So what are the prices like? Are these comparable?
They're pretty reasonable.
Comparable?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, you go to Starbucks, $2, not a big deal.
Recently, there has been a lot of controversy over the effects of caffeine on kids, even to the point of moving the pop machines out of the cafeteria. But now they've brought in a coffee shop, so I just had to ask.
I'm happy about that. I'm glad they have coffee here now.
I don't think it has that bad of an effect on people. It's more of a mental thing.
So you don't think it affects people at all?
No, maybe make you more awake, a little hyper, but you can control it.
What's the thought behind that?
I have no idea. I think coffee, well, I know coffee's got to have twice as much caffeine, and I've seen some kids just running around, I don't know, I think they were naked around the commons, and they're just getting hyper and just out of control.
Does caffeine really affect you at all?
Not really, man.
It doesn't make you jittery or anything?
No.
Caffeine controversy aside, SK Latte is serving up sweet stimulants and super doses of superior service.
So I was just wondering, what drink did you order?
Cherry Italian soda.
You think they did a good job?
I haven't tried it yet.
I haven't tried it. Why don't you try it? Give us your reaction shot. Is it good?
Tastes like Italian soda.
So remember, next time you come to school and you'd rather not be awake, there is someone serving up a Java Jolt just for you.
With SK Latte around, even Starbucks has some competition.
Our next story is the calendar of events. And while we're talking about calendars, Bridget, I just want you to know, you could be my calendar girl anytime.
Chad, that was the dumbest line I've ever heard.
Cool, why don't we watch the story?
Once a year, we take a day off to honor our veterans. So while you're at home on November 11th, take a second to think about these courageous men and women who fought to keep this country free. Thanksgiving break starts on November 24th with a half day and extends through the 25th and 26th. Well, it's that time of year again for fall sports. Everyone is in playoffs and fighting for that chance to go to state. Because of the uncertainty of the outcome, we can't give you dates and times for the games. But don't worry, we'll have winter sports schedules next month. With fall sports winding down, you might be looking for something to do after school. Instead of just sitting around, why don't you check out some clubs? South Kitsap offers many different clubs to suit everybody's interest. Here's a short list of some clubs and their advisors. If you'd like more information on clubs and their advisors, come to the ASB office. And that's what's going on at South Kitsap High School for the month of November. Have a happy Thanksgiving, and hey, eat a piece of pie for me.
Thanks to calendar events, we know what's going on this month.
Bridget and I are currently involved in a group called Acting Ensemble. We go around to each of the elementary schools performing a children's show. I play
Captain Magnificent.
And I play Miss Computer Nerd.
Why don't we get a behind-the-scenes look with this next story?
Broadway productions may be in the future for these young performers. The top actors and actresses of SK get ready to do their best performance. They're cast for the role of hero.
In the ensemble show, I play Dr. Bad Guy. He's the evil villain of the play, the antagonist.
My character's super happy girl, and she's always really happy and ditzy. It gets really annoying because she has to smile the whole time.
Auditions for the chance to be best of the best weren't easy. Role of director given to Miss Emmons. Ensemble is ready to show the school world what acting is all about. Getting ready for the fall play, Anne of Green Gables, Ensemble are hot on their feet to make this play the best ever.
I love Ensemble because it gives us a great opportunity to go out and perform and to see the kids.
Mostly I like acting. I mean, just being up on stage is fun. But then I hear we get to go play around with the little kids, and I'm a big kid person, so. Cool.
Now, just in case these delighted performers make it big, you saw them right here on Wolf Tracks. Here's the cast that make Acting Ensemble happen.
Jason Tabor.
Rubber Band Man!
Chad O'Connell.
Captain Magnificent.
Art Lim. Invisible Man.
Devlin O'Donnell, Super Happy Girl.
Hillary Mayfield. Mole.
Chris Ramsey. Dr. Bad Guy.
Lindsay Welliver. I'm Lort.
Denise Peterson.
Rat Woman.
Bridget O'Neill.
Miss Computer Nerd.
Chris Chansey.
Super Wild Guy.
Andrea Vannabas.
Lamp Chick.
Wait, what are you talking about? I'm bad.
All of Acting Ensemble, myself included, are very excited to be performing this year.
Every year around homecoming, there's a week called Spirit Week.
It's a chance for the students to show their pride in the school. They get to dress up for days like Toga Day, Hawaiian Day, and one day even got to wear their pajamas.
Let's check out the story.
I dressed up. Did you dress up?
Of course I dressed up. Up next is cross country.
But first, here's a few important messages you should watch.
What are these people doing? No, they're not taking naps in the middle of the day. These students are saving lives. Every year, South Kitsap's Prophets of Unity and the Puget Sound Blood Center team up for blood drives. If you'd like to save a life, the next blood drive is December 10th in the high school library. Students must be at least 16 to participate. Remember, every pint of blood can potentially save 3 lives.
I think it's important because there's a lot of needy people who need it, and I'm a healthy person, so I wanted just to donate what I can.
Have a heart, save a life, and give blood.
Did anybody go to that game against Bremerton last week?
Oh yeah, it was so cool. It was a total knockout. It was like 62-0. It was amazing.
So, did you ask that guy to homecoming yet?
No, not yet.
So why don't you just let me ask him for it?
Because you'll mess it up.
No, I won't.
If you tell him, then all his friends are gonna know.
Electromagnetic induction. Do you get it?
I pulled my hammy.
Jeez, Chad, you're really out of shape.
Well, can we slow down? My shoe's untied. I gotta...
Cross country's a lot harder than it looks, huh, Chad?
And why don't we watch the story on our team?
In 1997, the girls' cross country team won state. And last season, Zach Solberg was expected to place in the top 20 in the state competition. But with Zach Solberg injured and few returners from the girls' championship team, the team is now getting little recognition.
Well, I don't think a lot of people don't understand how much hard work we put through the summer and throughout the season, and people really don't consider this a sport.
For how good we did my ninth grade year, we didn't get as much recognition, I think, as we deserve.
But even with the little recognition, the cross-country team works hard and tests their limits every single practice.
We're gonna go on what we call a donut run. We're running up to Albertsons. Nobody else goes in except the coaches. You guys just hang out outside. We'll go in, bring out the donuts, and then what we're gonna do is eat a couple donuts.
Well, they test their limits almost every practice.
A lot of people on the cross country team just do it for the fun of it.
And I love this sport.
I run cross country because I started out to keep in shape, but it's a lot funner than I thought it would be.
And then it's the social aspect. I think a lot of kids run cross country, both boys and girls, because it's a lot of fun and we do lots of fun things.
But don't be fooled by all the fun and games. The cross country team is one of the toughest work ethics here at South Kitsap.
And I like the idea of going out there and just giving it your all physically. There's no question. You just go out every single race and you go as hard as you can.
Well, I think people don't understand how tough it is. It's a lot tougher than people think it is and make it out to be. It takes a really strong person mentally and physically to do it.
So, what are some of the workouts you guys do?
Well, we run.
We do 800s. We do 400s.
We run a lot.
We do mile tempo runs, we do gut busters, we do push-ups, we do 200s, we do fartleks.
Usually after we're done running, we run a little more.
With all that training, the girls have ran themselves into a first place ranking in state. And the boys? Well, let's just say it's a rebuilding year.
I definitely would say it's a rebuilding year.
We lost 5 of our top 7 seniors last year, our varsity guys. So yeah, it certainly is a rebuilding with or without Solberg. And that's just part of the sport. You lose.
Rebuilding year, maybe, but more like a year where it's going to maybe take us a little bit longer to to reach our goal just because we're so inexperienced. So.
But with recognition or without it, the cross-country team will always be giving 100% effort.
Thank you for watching this edition of Wolf Tracks.
We hope you enjoyed it. Signing out, I'm Chad O'Connell.
And I'm Bridget O'Neill.
See you next time.
Hey. Have you ever had this coffee? It's SK Logic Coffee. It's so good. Oh, my gosh.
You're strong.
On September 23rd, South Kitsap High School held an open house.
Why don't we do this over again? Because Bridget can't say Kitsap. Women can't kick.
Hmm. Bridget, okay, watch the show. What?
You almost pulled me down with you.
That was tough.
Oh! Oh!
That was the hardest kick you...
Cross country's a lot harder than it seems, huh, Chad? Chad?
It's a chance for the kids to show much.
Show much? Yeah. Show much.
Show much.
Show much.
Up next is cross country.
But fierce.
Cross country.
I think.
Never heard of it? Because I haven't.
I think you need.